Waters in Ramsey, New Jersey. We want to welcome you to our parish community. To those of you who are registered to flat note, if you might prefer to use a mobile device as an alternative to the screens, your virtual worship aid has recently been emailed to you. Also, this Mass is being recorded. It will be available later tonight in our music ministry channel, youtube.com, keyword OLMC Music Ministry. If you are a member of Flat Note, you will receive a direct link to the recording, and we do ask that you share that link with those who are homebound or unable to be with us this weekend due to sickness. We do like to make a special announcement that it is October already, and before you know it, it will be Christmas, and us here in the music ministry, we are already preparing for Christmas, but we really need to buff up both of our choirs, our adult choir and our youth choir, and we really need your help. If you wish to join any of our choirs, please see me after Mass today, or you can call the rectory during the week. And we thank you very much for that as well. At this time, we kindly ask everyone to silence all mobile phones and other electronic devices. And as always, as a courtesy to those who may be engaged in private prayer, we ask everyone to minimize any loud conversation in the moments leading up to Mass, as well as in the moments following the Mass. And we thank you for your understanding. And today the church celebrates the 28th Sunday in Ordinary Time, in Cycle Year C. As mentioned, Father Kevin DeVorbord from the Adorno Fathers of Ramsey, New Jersey, will be leading us in our worship this afternoon, and our cantor will be Lynn Costello.
Good afternoon, everyone. We begin with Sing a New Song. Please stand.
While being so ready to express our gratitude for favors received from human beings, we are less grateful to God, who is our greatest benefactor. A real Christian gives thanks to the triune God, both individually and as a member of the community, especially to the celebration of the Holy Eucharist, the greatest act of thanksgiving which we can offer to Him. Let us be grateful in a special manner as we remember our brothers and sisters and pray for them today. As we prepare to offer the great thanksgiving of the Eucharistic sacrifice, let us call to mind our sins, especially the sin of ingratitude. For the times we have neglected to thank you for all your generosity to us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For the times we have taken for granted your love and forgiveness and have failed to change for the better, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
The times we have taken our neighbor for granted and have failed to show our gratitude to them, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, remember Jesus Christ, raised from the dead, a descendant of David. Such is my gospel, for which I am suffering, even to the point of chains, like a criminal. But the word of God is not chained. Therefore, I bear with everything for the sake of those who are chosen, so that they too may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus, together with eternal glory. This saying is trustworthy. If we have died with him, we shall also live with him. If we persevere, we shall also reign with him. But if we deny him, he will deny us. If we are unfaithful, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I live in the seminary for 4 or 5 years already. 2018, and I was ordained in one of our parishes in South Carolina. Since we are missionary priests, we have different churches in the United States. We have three churches in South Carolina and one parish in New Jersey, which is in Lodi, St. Joseph. I'm not sure if you're familiar with the church, but the Adorno Fathers take care of that church. And I live in the seminary for, as I said, 4 to 5 years, and I am also a chaplain. I was a chaplain in one of the hospitals in New Jersey, in Hackensack Hospital. You probably know that. You know that, you know? And yeah, I have been here in the United States for maybe 7 or 8 years. I've read it for God, but. And I started my seminary formation in the Philippines. I'm from the Philippines, just like your pastor. That's why I thank him for having me here. It's my first time. I like this beautiful little church. You know, I remember our small chapel in the Philippines. It's like this, almost like this. And I think that's it for my introduction. I don't want to spend my homily just for introducing myself. And to know more about us, then ask your pastor to invite us, you know, to say Mass here. And I think that's about it. That's my introduction. And as I said, I started my seminary formation in the Philippines. And I remember when I was in the seminary, in college formation, one of the things that the seminarians should not mess up with is the bell, or the ringing of the bell. Because in those days, in the seminary, until now, the bell was a reminder for us, you know, that you have to do something, you know. If there is a bell, it's a warning to prepare ourselves for Mass, or to prepare ourselves for recreation, or maybe for lunch, for dinner. Bell is a vital part in our seminary formation. So if a seminarian messes up with the bell, or he rings the bell earlier or later, you know, later the schedule, then he will be the object of hate. You know, because if you don't ring the bell, we will not wake up. You know, it's like a wake-up call. You know, we didn't have cell phones to set the alarm. We had the bell. You know, you have to ring the bell exactly 5 a.m. You know, and then prepare yourself for Mass and for any other schedule. And the bell also was used for gathering us for like a meeting or like a special occasion or a special announcement that the superior wants to give to us. So ringing the bell is a, you know, serves as a wake up call for the seminarians and for the priests too, you know. And also in modern times in the hospital, if we hear the alarm goes off, then we get alarmed. You know, we get alarmed. Sometimes we get panic. Oh, what's going on? Is there any fire, or is there an emergency? Or maybe here in your house, if you hear the alarm goes off, then the fire department comes into your house, or the police will come to your house. So this bell, you know, or the ringing of bell, is vital in our life. Now, even in ancient times, if the church rings the bell, it's a sign of there's a coming disaster, something like that. No, so ringing the bell is vital in our times. I am saying this because in Jesus' time, you know, when people heard the sound of the bell, instead of gathering, you know, they tried to walk away from that source. They try to run away from that source. They got alarmed. Oh, there's a ringing of bell. Let's go. No? Go away from that. Why? Because in Jesus' time, those who ring the bell were lepers. Were lepers. As lepers, you know, they were obliged to cry out, unclean. It's disappointing, you know. I'm unclean, I'm unclean. Who would say that? No? So instead of saying that, they have this bell. you know, to notify the people that I am a leper. You should get away from my presence, you know. So in Jesus' time, those who ring the bell are lepers. Like in modern times, you know. If we know that someone has COVID, what do we do? We run away from that person. You know? But that was the beginning of the COVID, but now we treat them. You know, because we know how to deal with COVID. So it's like that. In Jesus' time, if you ring the bell, then people will hate you. Because you are a leper. You know, you are a leper. So lepers in Jesus' time were treated as outcasts. They forced to live on the borders of the society. They are objects of hate. No? They were feared because they don't want to contract the leprosy. And their leprosy did not only disfigure their body, no? It also caused them to be banished and rejected, no? In the community. They cannot participate like here, no? In the church's service. They are outcasts. Here in today's gospel, my dear friends, we see a portion of the law of Moses concerning leprosy. And in reading this portion, this gospel passage, we should be able to understand that the disease represents sin. Or their disease were caused by sin. And that's why, according to the law, for them to re-enter into the community, the individual had to go to the priest, had to be examined by the priest. Because diseases were the result of sin. So they had to go to the priest to be examined, not the doctors, but the priest. Because the priests were able to forgive sins, you know, and welcome them back to the community if the priest says that you are healed. So they had to go to the priest to be reunited in the community. And these 10 lepers knew their need of healing. In their desperate need, they called out Jesus from a distance, you know, to have pity on them. They had no illusions about their helpless situation. Their only hope was Jesus, because they knew that Jesus would heal them. And Jesus told them to go, you know, show yourselves to the priest, you know, that you are healed. And because of their faith, because of their trust in Jesus' words, they left. But only one returned. Only one returned. Jesus acknowledged their need and simply told them to go and show yourselves to the priest. And clearly, my dear friends, this was a reward for their unquestioning and trusting response to Jesus' words. And as I said, as the gospel says, only one returned. His gratitude was the source of healing. He was fully restored, both physically and spiritually. And this one, you know, the one who returned to Jesus, his faith has saved him and gave him a new life. And he was returned back to the relationship with God and with the community. So my dear friends, how many times we thank God for all the good things we have received? Most of us would probably say that we always thank the Lord every day, you know, we pray, I pray to God, I thank the Lord for this thing and that. That's all well and good, but how many times, you know, we thank those people who were instruments of healing? Like the doctors, like the nurses, do we say thank you to them? Or maybe the porter, you know, the porter in the hotel, or maybe the waiter or the waitresses. Do we say thank you to them? The cashier, no? The teachers and those people around us, do we say thank you to them? It is very difficult, my dear friends, to say thank you sometimes, no? To those who have done good to us or helped us in our needs. Saying this would not ourselves ease of the burden, but also help those people, no? To forget for the meantime their own hardships in their life. Gratitude makes our hearts soft, you know, and make the burdens of work light. So be grateful. Be grateful. Thank the Lord for everything, because it can inspire us to love. It can inspire us to love God more. It can inspire us to love our neighbors more. So whenever we see someone who helps us in our need, it should ring a bell to us, you know, that we should be grateful, thinking that in the midst of our hectic schedule, we must give thanks to the Lord, and we must give thanks to those people that God uses for our good. We should be grateful for everything. Every day is a wake-up call that we should thank the Lord for everything. Our alarm clock should remind us that we should thank the Lord for another day. Because sometimes we complain, oh, it's Monday again, it's time to work. No? Oh, it's Sunday, it's time to go to church. No? Stop nagging, but begin thanking God. Every day, there's a reason to be thankful. You know? Even the struggles we endure can be turned into blessings. In fact, that's exactly what happened in this story, in today's gospel. The awful suffering of leprosy was turned into grace from God. So let us be thankful. No? Let us express our gratitude to God. Let us express our gratitude to people, no, who help us in our time of need. And in this Mass, let us ask the Lord for the gift of healing, for the gift of gratitude, that we may be able to thank the Lord every day of our lives. Let us all stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father. Truly all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, He was crucified under Pontius Pilate, suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and esteem no man love no man. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the Lord of glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Taking our cue from the lepers in today's gospel passage, who were healed because of their faith, let us submit our petitions to the Lord with humble gratitude as we say,
please respond, Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the Church, the community of believers spread throughout the world, may she always be a shining example of faith and gratitude. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the Holy Father, the bishops, and all our spiritual leaders, may they always be signs and instruments of Jesus' readiness to assist the sick and the poor. Let us pray.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
For all of us gathered to thank the Lord for His goodness, may we constantly manifest our gratitude through a life of dedicated service to Him and our neighbor. Let us pray.
Lord, gracious
for the poorest among us, may they be restored to their dignity through adequate legislation and assisted in their needs through our generosity. Let us pray.
Lord,
for those who have died, especially Carmen Delbra, whom we remember in a special way at this Mass, and the recently deceased, may they live forever with Christ in the glory of the resurrection. Let us pray.
Lord,
let us pray in silence for our personal intentions. Let us pray.
Lord God, source of all goodness and strength, we thank you for all your generosity toward us. Continue to empower us to work for the good of the Church as brothers and sisters of Jesus, your Son, who lives and heals forever and ever.
Amen.
Our second collection today is for our parish assessments. Thank you for your continued generosity.
As we prepare our hearts and minds to receive the body and blood, soul and divinity of Jesus, we say the prayer of St. Francis.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness, we may pass over to the glory of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our good and our salvation, always and everywhere we give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you love in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sin we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Francis Caracciolo, our founder, St. Michael, the Archangel, and all the saints who have missed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Those at home who are unable to receive the body and blood, soul and divinity of our Lord Jesus Christ, we offer this prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and I unite myself wholly to you, never permitting to be separated from you. Approach the altar to receive the body and blood of Christ, we sing, Gift of Finest.
Let us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for some announcements.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
First of all, I'd like to officially welcome Father Kevin into our community. Let's give him a Father Kevin is a member of the Adorno Fathers, and he comes from Malwa, so all the way from Malwa to Natalie. Thank you, Father Kevin. Some parish announcements. During this weekend, the members of HEP, Helping Exceptional People, a fraternal organization of Catholic men and women dedicated to assisting the developmentally challenged, will be at the doors of the church asking for your support in helping them to continue their good works. Please be as generous as your means permit. The rectory will be closed October 10 in observance of Columbus Day. October 19, there is a meeting for parents of the children that will be receiving first penance. Meeting is 7 p.m. in the parish hall. The Women's Auxiliary is sponsoring another bus ride to Wind Creek Casino on Wednesday, November 9. The cost is $40 per person with $25 free slot play. The bus will leave OLMC at 9 a.m. and will be back in Natalie at approximately 6 p.m. If you are interested and would like to make a reservation, please contact Linda at 973-661-0090. Again, a gentle reminder regarding our annual parish appeal. If you have already given for the appeal, I thank you for your support and generosity. If you have not given for the appeal yet, I ask you to please pray over it, and hopefully you can consider giving for this worthy cause. Whatever you can give, thank you for your support. Next Sunday, October 16 at 5 p.m. is our Filipino Mass. Everyone is welcome. Tomorrow at the 12:15 Mass, I will be opening up that coin barrel there, the entrance of the church. So you still have time to put your $1,000 there. So 12:15 Mass, I will open up that coin barrel. Remember last year, we were able to collect more than $3,000 from that coin barrel. I don't know how much this year, but whatever we can put on the barrel, thank you for your support. You know, last month, there was a veteran journalist who visited the United States. And she attended my mass here at Lady Mount Carmel. She writes in one of the big newspapers in the Philippines, Philippine Star, and she wrote an article about Our Lady of Mount Carmel and about my homily. So she must have been listening to my homily. So now I have become famous now in the Philippines. The title of the article is "Prayer Opens Floodgates of Miracles." I have printed some of them. You can find them at the doors of the church. It's a very nice article. I think our church has been promoted worldwide, and a nice reflection, about prayer as well. So take a copy as you leave Mass today. It's a very, very insightful article about prayer. The name of the journalist is Maylin Mendoza Dayo. She writes at the Philippine Star, a newspaper in the Philippines. At this point, I'd like to invite Andrew to make an announcement.
Good evening once again, everyone. Well, Father Alex is about to become a little bit more famous still. This year, he celebrates his 36th anniversary
$5 per person, the entire semi-formal. We'd love if you attend. Again, it's from 5 to 9 p.m. at the Chandelier. There will be DJ and live music and all sort of different festivities. We ask that you RSVP by October 23rd, of course, of this year, by calling directly during normal business hours, or you can call Lydia Panham at 201-320-6646. And if you want to take that number down one more time, it's 201-320-6646. Once again, the date is Sunday, November 13th, at the Chandelier between 5 and 9 p.m. Tickets are $50 per person, and we do wish you will join us. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Andrew. 36 years. Father Kevin, 4 years?
4 years.
I remember when I was still young. Anyway, thank you so much. Please come if you are free. God bless you all.
I'd like to grab this opportunity to, you know, to thank the pastor, Father Alex, for having me here in this beautiful church. And this is my first time. And hopefully this will not be my last time. And I know this parish is known all over the world. Yeah, and it's live stream. I think I'm becoming famous too. Yeah, well, support the parish activities, the anniversary of Father Alex, the coin barrel. I think you need bigger barrel, Father, for this community. And yeah, if you have time or if you want to sign up in going to the casino, then you have spare change to give to the church. So I'd like you to, you know, support your parish, you know, the annual appeal. And as a missionary priest, I am also asking to support missionary priests, you know, like the Adorable Fathers. We are also known as the Adorable Fathers. I'm just kidding. So we live in Ramsey, New Jersey. If you have time to visit us, we have different shrines of saints. We have the Padre Pio, the Saint Joseph, Saint Francis Caracciolo, our founder, and different kinds of shrines in the seminary in our vicinity. So come and visit us in our seminary. We are only three priests, myself, my superior, and one retired priest. So we would love to have visitors, if you have time, visit us in our seminary. I think that's about it. Thank you for coming to this church. The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. As we continue on our journey, let us sing together, Sent Forth by God's Blessing.